Hello, and welcome to another episode of This Is My Architecture. I'm Erin from AWS, and I'm joined by Greg from Lockheed Martin. Hi, Greg. Welcome.
Hi, Erin. How are you doing?
Great. So why don't you tell us a little bit about Lockheed Martin before we dive in?
Okay. Lockheed Martin is the largest defense contractor in the world. We build a lot of really cool products and try to help the United States protect our borders.
Yeah, thank you. And what do you do there?
I am the principal systems architect, mm-hmm. and just a general disruptor. I help to introduce new technologies all around the corporation.
Like this?
Exactly. Like what we're going to talk about today.
Yeah. So I know that a lot of enterprises are trying to bring in, you know, voice skills into their everyday working life. And it looks like this is maybe something that you've accomplished. Because mm-hmm. I see Alexa for Business. Why don't you tell us a little bit about this product, this app?
Okay. Well, I was challenged by the CTO of the corporation mm-hmm. to provide him program management status anywhere, anytime.
Is that because they have to be maybe on site, or they can't do it if they're not in front of their computers?
Business travel, driving in their car to work in the morning, just whenever they want it. Right. Sometimes at night at dinner.
Okay, so I'm a program manager, is that mm-hmm. right? And I'm on my phone. I'm driving into work, hands free, and I asked about the status of my programs on my phone. So what happens next?
Okay, so you open the Alexa app, mm-hmm. and the Alexa app then goes into A for B, mm-hmm. Alexa for Business, and you would say, open the program management skill.
Okay.
That time, the program management skill would respond back to you with a welcome, and then say, what do you want to do?
Right. Show me the statuses of my programs.
Yes.
All right, so what's next?
What would be next, say, for example, you would say, tell me about the programs that are at risk.
Okay.
At that point, we would call the risk function mm-hmm. inside of Lambda, and what happens inside the risk function is a lookup into the model database that says these are the programs that are at risk of performance degradation. At that time, it does a string return that we then turn back into voice, and it responds back to the screen of the app uh-huh. with the text as well as reading the text to the user.
Oh, cool. So this has all the program information in this database, and you said this was Aurora MySQL?
Yeah, Aurora MySQL.
Right, but I see you have a DynamoDB table here. Why do you need to have two databases?
We had to solve an interesting problem.
Oh, okay.
So what in our problem was the fact that a lot of programs are abbreviations. We have acronyms are us at Lockheed Martin. So for example, if I have a program called ABC, uh-huh. 123, Alexa would try to read that back to you as ABC, bro, 123.
Or ABIC.
ABIC 123, right. So right. What we do is we convert it to a string that Alexa now understands by separating each character with a period.
Okay. So it will understand. It will just know that A period is A,
right.
and it's not a whole sentence.
Exactly.
And so that's stored in DynamoDB. Why'd you pick DynamoDB for this?
The quick return of a key-valued pair.
Oh, yeah. And it's super easy to store in there.
Exactly.
So. And Alexa for Business. Why'd you pick Alexa for Business instead of just writing a skill?
Well, the skill itself is called by Alexa for Business,
sure.
but in Alexa for Business for Enterprise.
Okay.
We want to use the enterprise application. We want to roll this out across our enterprise, but mm-hmm. I wanted to show leadership that we could be enterprise ready when we were ready to roll this entire application out. So no proof of concept, let's just do it.
And this will let you enroll users
yes.
and keep it as secure, and only those who have access, who should have access to it do.
Key.
Right. And you have these S3 buckets over here. What are these for?
Well, like we talked about, there's a program management database.
Okay.
An application
that sits out here. Okay.
Exactly. Okay. So what comes out of that application are two extracts.
Mm-hmm.
One extract is the program management skill data itself.
Okay.
This is the models, the data.
And this is like some Excel file.
Yeah, just an Excel okay. spreadsheet.
And then, so I'm somebody who's responsible for exporting this, and I plunk it right in S3.
Yep.
What happens next?
S3 then fires a trigger mm-hmm. into Lambda. This Lambda function then enumerates the spreadsheet and replaces it into the SQL database, in columnar format.
Okay, so now it's in a format that this skill can understand
mm-hmm.
and then I can interact with it.
Exactly.
And so you kind of have the same pattern down here?
Exactly. We have an abbreviations
mm-hmm.
table.
Mm-hmm.
So the same spreadsheet, another spreadsheet with the abbreviations and their pronunciation.
Oh, nice.
Gets put, triggered, this Lambda function. This Lambda function then creates what would look like a key value pair like we just described here.
Okay, great.
In table format.
Well, great. Thank you so much for coming here today and showing us how you have enabled your enterprise to use an Alexa skill to help people be much more productive while they're on the go.
Anytime.
All right. And thank you for watching. This is My Architecture.